don't know if it's actually going to matter all that much, because, look, this expansion's mined out, and as soon as it is, Dalai Lama can just move all his forces up here and mine out this expansion. So, really no, I mean, it was an effective drop in the sense that he killed a lot, but he didn't really kill anything all that useful, as at this point, SCVs are pretty much useless for Dalai Lama, as he has no remaining base to mine from. But wow, this is just crazy back and forth. Dalai Lama just still needs to spend his money, though. I mean, look at all these production buildings, constantly having units in production, but just not enough. I mean, he's almost out of space for production buildings, which is kind of ridiculous. I mean, he almost needs to just move out here and fill this whole area with production buildings just to allow himself to get a huge army. But he is maxed at this point, so I think we are going to see some huge battle. I'm looking at White Rod's forces. White Rod down almost 50 food. I don't know if White Rod's continuing to build workers. No, he's not. He needs to just use his money and cap out his army. And so it looks like Dalai Lama is going to move up here. Going to siege up his tanks and do tons of damage against this force here. Even some nice Emps going down. But White Rod actually managing to get away without taking too much damage. And I really have no idea who's going to win this. Neither player really seems to be able to break the other player's base. And White Rod actually doing a drop down here, but it really doesn't matter. I mean, it's not, none of these things are mining still. Going to kill all these SCVs. But now a huge battle going down up by White Rod's main. But tons of storms and archons being used to great effect. Look how fast that mass bio just crumbles to those forces. But I don't know if it's going to be enough. So now White Rod did lose that battle, very low on army count. So he's actually not as low as I thought. White Rod actually has some forces, but they're kind of spread out across the map. And Dalai Lama even bringing most of his SCVs to try and do this final push. And I don't know, looks like White Rod might be in a little bit of trouble here. But Void Rays out of nowhere. So this is not good at all for Dalai Lama, not having any forces to... that are anti-air. Oh no, so this just simple mistake of not having enough marines in his army might end up costing him the game. These two Void Rays are just going to be able to rampage through here and decimate these tanks. Dalai Lama can't afford to lose units here, but he did manage to bring them back without really dying to these Void Rays. But wow, crazy stuff going on all over the place. And White Ra, I think White Rod's looking really good here, just because he has about as many resources as Dalai Lama, but he still has mining bases. And Dalai Lama didn't brought all of his SCVs, but I think that was kind of a mistake, because he still could have mined a little bit of some resources from up here. I would like to see him finish that off first. But I don't know, it's so trivial, I don't think that it might not be the deciding factor in the game. So once again, Dalai Lama is going to try and move out here. Has some more anti-air, a couple Vikings as well. Should be able to deal with the few Void Rays of White Rod. It looks like White Rod once again is just transitioning back into a ground army. Just doing that switch to force Dalai Lama to switch it up. But a great storms going in from White Rod, doing tons of damage to these tanks. And still maybe not enough. Okay, yeah, he does have some Vikings on the way, so he will be able to stop these Void Rays. Now White Rod kind of looks like he is in a little bit of trouble, not really having the forces he needs to deal with this tank push. I'm going to lose a bunch of probes here, but that's not really what I'm worried about. He just does not have the forces up here to stop this push. And Dalai Lama looks like he's just going to be able to slow crawl into and finish off two of the three remaining mining expansions of White Rod. Oh man, so this game is just crazy back and forth. But it looks like White Rod is going to try and poke in here with his Zealots. Some nice Emps actually catching all the Zealots, and oh, look how fast they melt. So this is not looking good for White Rod at all, having no forces up here to defend. And I don't know how he's going to be able to turn this one around. I have no idea, White Rod. You just need to get a lucky battle, I guess, where you manage to snipe a number of the tanks. I mean, that'd be my best guess. What is going on around in White... Oh! So White Rod going for a Dark Shrine! And this might catch Dalai Lama completely unaware. And if he manages to get off, like, or get out, like, I don't know, just a number of Dark Templar, he should be able to come in here and just finish off, this entire force by Dolly Lamer. Dolly Lamer only had 700 resources, and he has no starports with tech labs, so he won't even be able to build a Raven. He'll have a couple scans. Okay, so he has one orbital command landed, so he'll have a couple scans. These, I guess, can land as well. But if White Rob plays his cards right, it'll be very hard for Dolly Lamer to deal with these Dark Templar. So here we go, a couple Dark Templar moving in here, one-shotting Marines left and right. Looks like he's splitting them up, though, which is exactly what he needs to do. Force Dolly Lamer to waste any scans, but Dolly Lamer doesn't even seem to know these Dark Templar are there. And, oh, this would be just a crazy comeback by White Rot if these Dark Templar allow him to turn this game around. And the final mining expansion of White Rot is going to go down to these Vikings. There's not really much he can do about it, but once again, Dolly Lamer completely out of resources and has no detection. So, wow, I don't know what Dolly Lamer can do to keep himself. I think he's going to lose. He has scans, but as long as White Ra splits up his Dark Templar, Dolly Lamer is just not going to be able to do anything. And White Ra actually warping in some units to save his last mining expansion, so that was a very good move by White Ra. And Dolly Lamer trying to put his command centers at a position where there are some minerals left, but he just has no workers. If we look at the worker count, 13 workers to 6 workers. So, wow, both players basically tapped out. This game is crazy, crazy. But I don't know. Dolly Lamer is going to have some crazy scans to deal with these Dark Templar. And there we go, one scan going down. I wonder how much energy he has remaining. Looks like he has 3 scans of that guy, a full set of scans. So he has a ton of scans to deal with these Dark Templar. It's really going to come down to whether White Ra is able to... Oh no, and some crazy storms going down though in the meantime, weakening this force by Dolly Lamer. And looks like he might be able to just defend with a few High Templar here with great storm usage. And White Rum sniping these bases slowly with his Void Rays. So just using all the units that he has at his disposal. And I don't know. Looks like Dolly Lamer is going to be able to come in here and do a lot of damage to White Rot. And because White Rot does not have a lot of Dark Templar, looks like that remaining Dark Templar does go down. But we do have some Zealots over here going to be able to clean up this force. And 2 Void Rays against a Marine and a Ghost. So I think the Void Rays will be able to win. A couple of Ems going down, that'll definitely help. But if White Rot's Void Rays do kill all of the anti-air from Dolly Lamer, he wins almost by default. Oh, and looks like it's not going to quite happen. Void Rays are going to go down. This is way too close to call. White Rot is the only one that has a mining base. I don't know. It looks like Dolly Lamer just does GG. Wow, so that was just insane back and forth game. So I hope you guys enjoyed that game as much as I did for my first StarCraft II Legacy cast. If there's any suggestions or comments or anything about my casting, let me know, and I will do my best to try and fix any issue I have. So, once again, like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed my first cast, and with that, we'll see you guys later.